playing for Coach Pop, it's like legendary. I know he wants what's best for me. Obviously, if he's on me pretty hard, he sees something in me that I may not even see myself at the moment, but I know that it's always for something bigger.
I thought I was strong mentally, but man, when you're with Pop, you find some new ways. I never thought I had it, and he definitely brought the best, you know, out of me.
He is the most fascinating person I have ever covered.
He's a remarkable man.
I mean, Pop is simply the best. He cares about his people.
One of the all-time greatest, for sure.
I became way better player because of having a coach like that. That made me understand how a team worked, but also outside the court. He started to become like a father figure. He became way more than a coach-player relationship.
Yes, the magic of Pop.
Had a very good relationship. I think we always respected each other, always felt that he had my best interest in hand.
He didn't have a problem communicating. Even if you didn't like how it was communicated, he was very blunt, very straightforward. He wanted to transform the culture of the team to a more disciplined team.
He was all business, like on the court and during practice. But away from it, he was just really friendly and kind. He just showed a lot of consideration and care for my well-being away from the court. And that's what I appreciated. And that's how we really grew to become friends.
Yeah, but with Coach Pop, it was always like a up and down, you know, love, hate, you know, because he was so demanding and pushed me very hard. At the end of the day, for me, I wanted to win, and I know it was coming from a place that he was very competitive and he really wanted to win too. And so that's what I respected. You know, I wanted to win too. I wanted to be the best point guard in the NBA. And so we pushed each other.
You know, Pop pushes those buttons, right? And he sees the reaction. He's constantly studying, and he knows which buttons to push.
I think he just also knew certain guys that can handle it. He also knew that it would make me better and that it would push me. And I appreciated it because I knew I needed that, and that made me the player I am today.
Obviously, if he's on me pretty hard, he sees something in me that I may not even see myself at the moment, but I know that it's always for something bigger. So I just keep pushing and pushing and pushing. And I think his coaching really, like the way he, you know, communicates with it, really motivates me. You know, keeps me hungry.
He was a motivator, and he pushed me hard. Expected a lot from me, not only like on the court, but in the realm of trying to be a leader, trying to teach me how to be a leader, and try to teach me how much my words and my actions affected the team. He became the guy that I kind of looked to for advice, for leadership.
And Pop's ability to be able to just to be straight up with you, I think that's allowed him to be so successful. And guys have respected that more. You know, guys in our league don't want it to be sugar-coated. They don't want to be baby. They don't want to be, you know, told what they want to hear all the time. They want to be challenged. They want to be coached. They want to be, held accountable. And
people talk about culture a lot in the NBA and the Spurs culture. And as much of anything, and I think Pop recognized this and understood this, it was Tim Duncan, Manu Ginobili, Tony Parker, and others that allowed themselves to be coached and coached hard. And listen, when your best player, Tim Duncan, allows for the head coach to go at him and to coach him hard and to challenge him, it allows him to do that with everybody on the roster. And I think that was such a big part of Pop's success and the team's success were those relationships.
It's about communication and loyalty and commitment and consistency, all of the things that he preaches on a day in and day out basis. And he's a guy that you can have a relationship with.
Pop could coach guys really hard because he spent so much time beforehand developing the personal relationship, that allowed them to understand that everything he was demanding out of them was nothing more than he was demanding out of himself.
The thing I've always respected about Pop, more than I think anything else outside the four lines, is his understanding of relationships. He treated everybody the same. So when we would get in circles and we would stretch, he had his finger on the pulse of his team. Not a lot of coaches have that, where he understands what's going on in your life and directs his conversation to you about you and what's going on in your life. That is, to me and most players, that significant of a coach that cares.
The way that Pop just inherently has this ability to touch people in that way, to take appropriate time with people in that way, and have it be as consistent as it is and as heartfelt as it is, makes him incredibly special and incredibly unique. And every player that has had the chance to be in a huddle with him would tell you that he represents so much more than what coaching is supposed to represent to you. He represents how you should conduct yourself.
To be able to have that magic and make everybody feel connected, or truly make everybody feel one, is a special attribute. His X's and O's obviously are fantastic, but being a people manager, he's the best in the business.
All the players we've had, it's a credit to the scouting staff too. They bring in people of character. And again, like we said, we don't have to have all Boy Scouts, but people who understand that there are things bigger than themselves and bigger than basketball.
I think it's the relationships that he develops with his teams, with his players, and he spends so much time getting to know them as people and getting to know their families and caring about them as people and caring about their families. And he really could care less about whether we win or lose that game. What he cares about is us growing together, coming together as a team, about growing as people, as growing as humans, about learning about each other and about the world in ways that will help us be better humans. And if, oh, by the way, we win a game or we win a championship, that's the byproduct of pounding the rock.
It's more than just basketball. It's a way of life. And that's what Pop and RC teach you. They teach you to be selfless. They teach you to work hard. They teach you and show you every day what it means to give yourself away to others.
There was a level of humanity that, in my opinion, pushed the culture. And it started with Pop and RC. When I got there, I kept hearing getting over yourself. And I didn't know what that meant. It's people that push that culture. You know, selfless character, pound the rock. Like, that comes off of my tongue like a song.
Any success that we've had, RC is a major, major component of that, because we've been hooked at the hip for all these years making these decisions.
Somebody who I've shared a lot of great times together with, both as professionals and as humans.
We've done that for all these decades, and without his counsel, without me being able to throw things off of him, it would have been much more difficult to do some of the things that we've done with our team.
His innate curiosity about the world, I think, allows him to meet everybody where they are. So if you're Tim Duncan, he'll meet you there at that level of talent. But if you're Patty Mills, he'll meet you here at this level of where you are. And he still gets everybody buys in. And they keep buying in. You know, and so that takes somebody who is comfortable enough to listen to other people and other people's experiences as human beings. We all have interesting experiences. All of us came from somewhere. We have an origin story. You know, all of us have had hardships and we've had tough times. And But the thing that makes, I think, Popovich, you know, kind of unique is that he really does listen. He really does care about guys and where they're from and what their family life is like. And that makes him a very special guy.
Playing for Pop was special, man. For me, you know, it was amazing. You know, he cares about his players on and off the court. He cares about you growing on the court and learning the game, but he also cares about you off the court.
It was times when we played bad the game before and we'd come in and we'd see the chairs lined up and we're thinking like, oh man, this is gonna be a film session. This is gonna be Pop getting on us, and he would talk about life. He would talk about what was going on in Iraq at the time. He would just talk about, you know, whatever was in the news, and it just kind of brung you back, and he was just kind of like, we get to play basketball today, which just made you kind of recalibrate and understand that it was a gift to play. Just put it out there on the floor, but there are, you know, bigger things in life than basketball.
I think the biggest lesson that I learned from Pop over the years is that basketball is just a game, and there's more important things in life than this basketball.
I think what makes him truly unique is he's sort of an old-fashioned term, but he's a Renaissance man. Like, players understand who are part of that organization that, well, basketball is why they're there and winning is critically important. There's more to life than basketball. He makes sure that his players take advantage of this platform that the NBA offers, whether it's the travel, whether it's understanding the communities they're in, and broadly in terms of what's happening socially and politically in this country. Like, it makes him truly a unique coach, not just in the NBA, but in all sports.
Obviously, he has an unbelievable coaching legacy. Look at all of these head coaches who have come under his tutelage. He has mentored so many great players and coaches. And as you said, he just told us that this is one of his legacies that he will leave in the NBA. It's these people that he has impacted their lives and helped to make them at the very highest of their profession as they've gone on to bigger opportunities.
I mean, I'm still waiting for somebody to, you know, make a legitimate poster. Like a legitimate family tree. And it could be his, you know, Sam Presti, like there's a front office GM thing. It could be his, you know, video guys that started someplace and have ended up wherever. And then you get the obvious ones like, you know, Monty or Bud or me or, you know, Will Hardy or whatever. Like, There's chunks of it from our seaside to Pop side to on court to off court. You want to look at something impressive, you know, have a look at that family tree.
I was fortunate that I shared an office with Pop. Pop was extremely gracious with his time, his mentorship, his love for my family, and I'll never forget that. And I'm fortunately a part of that tree, and I love being one of those branches, and like I said, I owe an extreme amount to the Spurs organization.
Pop is so respectful to his assistants and their input.
Of tasks throughout the organization, like he's so good at delegating and making everybody feel empowered and a part of it. Like, I think that's one of the things that isn't talked about enough, is that one of the reasons why people feel so connected to the place is that you really had skin in the game. Like, he empowered you every day to go out and do it and to carry out the message of the organization.
Truly, there's nobody that's been more influential in my life, shaping my life from a professional standpoint and in lots of other ways than he has been.
We'll all go out and, you know, kind of forge our own identities, but the foundational aspects of coaching, I think we all learned a great deal from Pop, and we'll carry that on.
Pop gave me so many opportunities, RC gave me so many opportunities, and when the time was right, when Mike Budenholzer got his opportunity, he had a lot of faith in me, knowing this guy, no matter where he started in the organization, year after year after year, he put in the work, he put in the sweat and the tears, he was willing to learn, he was willing to be coached, he was a Spurs guy.
And I just think, like, when you look at the extensiveness of this tree we're talking about, it goes layer upon layer upon layer. It really would be a very, I think, cool visual for somebody to take the time to make.
That's probably my, not probably, it is my greatest satisfaction. when I go around the country and seeing these guys and one gal, Becky, when we go places, is still a thrill for me.
Gregg Popovich moves past Tom Nelson as the all-time winningest coach in NBA history. 1,336 regular season victories.
Coach Pop, you deserve it. And we all love you, and we're glad we're here to be able to enjoy this moment with you.
Thank you, man. Yeah.
I think the qualities, that allow Coach Pop to have that success was his ability to continue to stay above the curve of what the game was. You know, if you look, you know, when he first started and started first coaching in the 90s, it was all about like the big man, the big man, the big man. You know, you have a guard, you throw it into the big, and everybody work off the big. And obviously he was, blessed with such a great, two great legendary bigs, you know, first David Robinson, and then in the late 90s he was able to draft Tim Duncan, and those guys are legendary. And then when I started coming into the league, you know, as the game started to change a little bit, where it became a lot of pick and roll, a lot of guard play, he was able to adapt and change his teams to now, okay, Manu Ginobili, you know, and Tony Parker running a lot of pick and rolls, spreading the floor, surrounding Tim Duncan with shooters and wings that can defend, you know. And, you know, it takes a special coach to be able to adapt to the game in different eras and still be successful. You saw Pop do that from the early 90s to the late 90s, early 2000s, late 2000s, you know, and even here in the teens. This is, and it's the reason why he's the winningest coach in NBA history.
I got there in 99. I think it was his third year, the beginning of his third year coaching. And he was very conservative. He was, if you're a college football fan, he was Woody Hayes. 3 yards in a cloud of dust. He was gonna hand the ball off every time and play great defense and do that over and over and over again. And it made sense because we had, Tim Duncan and David Robinson. So, you know, two of the great defenders in the league. And we were gonna be conservative offensively and give those guys the space they needed inside. And we won a championship. You know, you fast forward to the 2014 finals, you know, 11 years later, and I think that was the most beautiful basketball team I'd ever watched. The passing, the ball movement, the spacing, the three-point shooting. So to think from, you know, my first experience with Pop in 99, where it was just dump the ball in and stand and stay out of David and Tim's way, you know, 15 years later, it's this ballet of passing and cutting and movement and flow and beauty. That alone, I think, showed you just how much Pop evolved, you know, in his thinking as a coach, and how open he was to change.
I've never seen a greater coach than him. I think the ability to adjust to the different styles of play, you know, the enormous number of three-point shots that are taken today, he's adjusted to that. And it takes a great coach and a great mind to be able to keep up with today's game.
I think he's one of the best ever, or the best ever, in adjustments, whether it's in-game or obviously taking the talent he's had and changing the whole style from an inside-out team to next thing you know, you go a couple years, they're a team that's shooting threes, they play small ball, they play big. Pop is always been ahead of the game or ahead of the curve or willing to adjust, I think, on the fly better than most coaches.
The energy, right? Like, to change takes energy, and to look at things differently, especially when you've had success doing it one way for so long. If you look over the course of the span that he's been here, you know, they've adapted multiple times. And again, now seeing him dance with the young guys before practice, it just never ceases to amaze me how he's amazing at meeting people where they are, and also at the same time building the framework to take you where you need to go. And so it's just a unique and amazing person. It's been said before, but it can't be said enough. Just a special, special leader and a special, special person.
NBA head coach Gregg Popovich and the San Antonio Spurs
have agreed to a new five-year extension. The five-time champion has coached San Antonio since 1996. He's the all-time leader in coaching wins.
Pop loves coaching. Why does he coach? Because every year is the new ingredients to make this incredible, exciting. You don't know what's going to come out. And the creativity it takes to get the most out of the team, that's an art form.
You know, it's crazy playing for a coach like Coach Pop. He's a legend, the best to ever do it. I've learned so much from him. I think it's been out of this world. And I never really, you know, expected to go into the league and already be coached by a great. So it means the world to me, and you know, I feel like it's helped me a lot, and it's going to help me in the future.
When I think of Pop, I think of a life for a guy that really loves the game of basketball, loves people, loves to grow and have relationships with his players and his staffers, and now motivated by a potential challenge of trying to rebuild this thing.
Anytime I think of Pop, the thing that has shocked me over the years is he has maintained his competitive edge under an incredible level of endurance. And, you know, to coach in the NBA, you need that. To coach as long in the NBA, you certainly need it. To be as successful as he has been coaching as long as he has, you definitely need it.
To have you out there, welcome to Salt Lake City. Our next honoree's coaching career spans more than 50 years at the college and pro level. He began his NBA journey in 1988 with stops as an assistant in San Antonio and Golden State before a return to the Spurs as their general manager, then head coach. Nearly 30 years later, he still stalks the Spurs sidelines as the longest tenured active coach in American sports history and the NBA's career leader in coaching wins. He led the Spurs to winning records in his first 22 seasons to surpass Phil Jackson for the most winning seasons in NBA history. Along the way, he's won five NBA titles, a championship resume to which he added as a U.S. men's national team coach with a gold medal performance in Japan. Today, he's one step closer to a gold-plated induction into the Naismith Hall of Fame. Named a finalist as a coach by the North American Committee, Gregg Popovich.
Gregg Popovich has been the perfect coach for this situation. He brings humility. He brings perspective that easy to lose perspective. You start having success, you those teams, those old Lakers teams, it's hard to keep them together. Not just because of money, but because of attitudes and egos. Having someone like Pop to manage those type of challenges, potential challenges, has been amazing. And our run for our 25-year run has been historical. There's just no other way to say it. I mean, what we've accomplished, particularly as a small market team, I think has been miraculous.
Words won't be able to describe how much he's meant to me in my life. More importantly, off the court, and what I've learned for him, they're all values that I will cherish for a long, long time. And he's been a big part of my growing up.
He has a soft side about him that's really endearing, and that's why so many people love him in the community.
Gregg Popovich has provided, I think we're making clear to everyone that, well, they're there to win. This is about something much bigger than basketball, and he's been such a leader and also such an influence on my life as well.
I've often said that, to create a culture, to have success in this league, consistency and longevity have to be paramount. You can't change things every 2 years, whether it's the players, the coaches, that sort of thing. You got to stick with something and believe in something. But it can't happen unless you have a great synergy between ownership and coaching staff and management and players. That all has to work. And so over time, it develops an unbelievable trust. And that carries through the whole organization, where now management and coaching staff can understand it's not about blame if a draft pick doesn't work or a game gets lost. You move on and you respect each other in that sense.
more than anything. He's a life coach, he's a basketball coach, he's a mentor, he's everything to all of us every single day. And I think this organization has felt that for countless years and hope to feel them for countless more going forward.
The standard you set, you showed up after I got drafted, you came to my island, you sat with my friends, my family, you talked with my dad. I thought that was normal. It's not. You're an exceptional person. Thank you for teaching me about basketball, but even beyond that, teach me that it's not all about basketball. It's about what's happening in the world, about your family. Thank you for being the amazing human being that you are.